there are some very significant policy gains made from this perspective influenced by Adam Smith within the mold of Secretary Albert Gallatin.
Yeah, absolutely. And so this, however much I criticize the Jefferson administration, I call it failed. A lot of that criticism is especially relates to the second administration. The first administration, there were some crucial moderations. The Louisiana Purchase had a lot of problems. Overall, though, I mean, he was fairly successful. You know, libertarians, you know, beggars can't be choosers, so to speak. So, you know, when there are being steps used to reduce the size of the government, to cut down taxes, to cut military spending, et cetera, I mean, that's very good. So the first administration overall, in my book, you know, gets about an A. Gallatin was the one bright spot, you know, in Jefferson's cabinet. Right. He was the Secretary of the Treasury. I don't agree with everything he did. He was pro Bank of the United States, which led to some issues. But he was very frugal. He was very influenced by Adam Smith. So he was appreciative of free markets. He was against sort of Hamiltonian mercantilism, et cetera. And through the individuals you've mentioned, guys like John Randolph and Nathaniel Macon in Congress, they were able to reform the government in certain respects, get rid of the whiskey tax, right, which led to a huge decline in the number of Treasury officials in the government. So it was sort of a quasi-permanent reform. They were able to downsize parts of the military. Okay, there were some issues with the Navy, and that had to deal with the Barbary pirates, but Gallatin wasn't behind that. That was Jefferson's fault. They did continue to sell off stock in the government's ownership of the Bank of the United States, which sort of privatized the institution a little bit. These are all important reforms. They deserve to be mentioned, and really the main credit for them should go to Albert Gallatin, as you discussed.